Hello everyone, welcome to Irfan CFPS YouTube channel. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the most important topic, system components of water spray fixed fire protection system. So before we move ahead, I would like to thank you all for your amazing support. Please subscribe for more and keep supporting the channel. So first system component would be spray system piping. Steel and copper pipes can be used as per NFPA 15. Other piping materials can be used, however, they have to be investigated for proper suitability and listed for this service. Copper tubes, which includes type K, type L and type M, all are acceptable as per NFPA 15. Pipe bending shall be permitted as allowed by the listing. In most of the cases, we are going to bend the pipe as per our project site requirements. Pressure limitations and wall thickness for steel pipe shall be in accordance with NFPA 15 clause 5.3.5. All pipes, including specially listed pipe, shall be marked along its length by the manufacturer. And the marking shall be visible on every piece of pipe over 2 feet long. Bending of pipe or pipe bending requirements shall be in compliance with section 5.3.9. You can refer NFPA 15 edition 2022. Minimum pipe size for steel and galvanized pipes shall be 1 inch. And for copper and stainless steel pipe, it should be 3/4 inch or 19 mm. Steel pipes used in manual and open systems shall be galvanized on internal and external surfaces in accordance with NFPA 15 table 5.3.1. We have extracted NFPA 15 table 5.3.1 in order to get the specifications for pipes or tubes. As you can see on your screen, the materials and dimensions is shown on left side and the standard which is used for the particular pipe is mentioned on the right hand side. So all these pipes can be used as water spray system piping. Let us discuss the second most important component, fittings. Galvanized fittings shall be used where galvanized pipe is used. Fittings shall be extra heavy pattern where pressures exceed 175 psi. However, standard weight pattern malleable iron fittings for 6 inch in size or smaller shall be permitted where pressures do not exceed 300 psi. Schedule 30 pipes with size 8 inch and more or schedule 40 pipes size less than 8 inch shall not be joined by threaded fittings. This is the most important point you need to remember. And then welded fittings shall be permitted to join water spray system piping. Grooved fittings can also be used. However, in most of the cases, since the water spray system is a dry pipe system, hence we are going to consider the welded fittings only. Type of fittings which can be used for water spray system is shown or mentioned in this particular table 5.4.1. This has been extracted from NFPA 15. Hangers and supports, it has been already discussed in NFPA 13. Video series, you can watch that. So selection of hangers shall be in accordance with NFPA 13 for water spray system as well. For outdoors or where corrosive conditions exist, the hanger shall be galvanized, suitably coated or fabricated from corrosive resistance materials. Control valves can be gate valves or butterfly valves. Valves controlling water flow must be listed. Listed control valves cannot be closed in less than 5 seconds due to risk of water hammer. A non-indicating valve must have a T-wrench on site for operation and can be used where acceptable to AHJ. A non-indicating valve will be installed underground. Listed underground valves equipped with listed indicator posts shall be permitted in underground applications. I have discussed about control valves, gate valves and butterfly valves in my NFPA 13 video series. You can watch that for more detailed information. Water spray system will have system actuation valves which will be automatic. So basically system actuation valves and accessories shall be listed, and the actuation valves shall be provided with manual means of actuation independent of automatic release system and detection devices. Drain valves and test valves shall be approved. Automatic systems require deluge valves which must be regulated hydraulically, electrically or mechanically to deliver water as needed. I will discuss about a particular concept of water spray system at the end of this session. So make sure to watch the entire video so that you can understand the concept clearly. Other major components includes pressure gauges, strainers, alarm bells and so on. So for nozzles, you can check my previous session, basics of water spray system. Pressure gauges shall be listed and shall have a maximum limit not less than twice the normal working pressure where installed. Strainers shall also be listed and specifically used in water supply connections. Alarm bells can be mechanical or electrical. In electrical, we can use like horn strobes, etc. and they must be listed for use with this service. Fire department connection. It is used as an auxiliary water supply to the spray system, and FDC shall consist of 2 by 2.5 inch connections using NH international threaded swivel fitting as specified in NFPA 1963. A single outlet connection is also acceptable where pipe to 3 inch or smaller riser. FDC shall be equipped with proper plex or caps, properly secured and easy removal by fire department. So this is the most important slide which I am going to discuss. If you want to know the concept of water spray system, you need to watch the complete video. So basically in this particular slide, we are protecting hexane pumps by using water spray network. So as I already discussed and informed, deluge valve is the main component in water spray system. However, in order to actuate this deluge valve, we need to get some kind of signal which can be either mechanical, electrical or hydraulic signal. So in this particular case, we are using mechanical signal, which means wet pilot line with pilot sprinklers. Apart from that, please note this wet pilot line will be filled with water and this line will be connected to the deluge valve. And next point would be, like above the deluge valve, this particular blue line will not be filled with water since we are using open type nozzles. If you want to understand the types of nozzles which has to be used, you can refer to our previous session, basics of water spray system. So water flow begins only when the system is triggered or the deluge valve clapper is opened. So basically the water will be available in this particular network before the deluge valve. After the deluge valve, the water spray line will be dry type. So this particular network is connected from the pump room and through underground piping which is equipped with underground gate valve and post indicator. This is then connected to the above ground deluge piping. Before the deluge valve, a gate valve and a strainer are installed to ensure clean water flow and maintenance purpose, while another gate valve can be used above the deluge valve. However, it's not shown in this particular figure. Finally, the FDC connection links to the deluge network, and a check valve can also be used, or check valve has to be used in the FDC line. And apart from that, how the system work? I will explain you how the system will work. When the fire is detected near the hexane pumps, the pilot sprinklers will be activated, and which causes the pressure in the wet pilot line to drop. This pressure drop triggers the deluge valve to open and water flows through the entire piping system, flooding the area with water from all the open nozzles to suppress the fire. So I hope you understand the concept of water spray deluge system with pilot actuation. The concept is same for other types as well. Only the difference is the signal which we are going to receive to the deluge valve is the only difference. Apart from that, everything is same for other actuations as well. Next class would be very interesting since we are going to dive into the concept of design. Thanks for watching. If you like my content, you can give me feedback in the comment section. I request you to subscribe to my channel to get more information about fire protection design.